Hello children, so today let us start with a new chapter, that is lesson number 3, soil erosion and conservation. So children, what is soil? Soil is a naturally occurring loose covering of the broken rocky material and decaying organic matter present on the surface of the earth. So that means it occurs naturally, soil. It's a gift from our nature. Then it is loose covering of the broken rocky material. In the previous chapter, you learned about rocks and minerals, right? Then weathering of rocks causes the rocks to break down into fragments, small bits and pieces of rocks. Again and again, further and further, it gets broken up into small pieces. So that is nothing but the loose covering of the broken rocky material. And decaying organic matter means, organic matter here refers to the living organisms. So the living component, for example, any organic matter in sense like any vegetables, fruits, or even some animals, when they die, what happens? They will be buried inside the soil, and after a few days they start decaying. So that is why now here it is mentioned as soil is a naturally occurring loose covering of broken rocky material and decaying organic matter present on the earth's surface. Okay, now this soil, whenever the dead organisms die, I said they keep decaying in the soil, correct? So it, that matter is called as the humus. The dead and decaying matter is referred to as humus. So what happens is, this humus contains lot of nutrients and minerals in them. Okay, so whenever the organic matter, they decay, they will give the soil their nutrients and minerals, and that is why such soil will call such soil as fertile soil, and plants will be able to receive all kinds of nutrients and minerals and grow very nicely. So humus rich soil is called as fertile soil, and this kind of soil is suitable for the plants to grow. Okay, now in soil, children, we don't exactly call soil as dead. Why? Means soil will have many number of microorganisms inhabiting in them. Okay, that means lot of microorganisms live inside this soil. The tiny pores, whatever is present in between each particles, the soil particle, it helps for the organism to grow in them. Okay, and you can find lot of variety of insects also, and some of the animals also do live inside the soil, correct? So we will not call soil as dead, as it keeps changing, the living organisms, and always the soil keep changing. You have also studied the different kinds of soil, correct? Like red soil, black soil, alluvial soil, clay soil. So it keeps always changing. Now soil is a very important resource for everyone. How? So the first point is, it acts as a home for many animals and insects. Okay, even plants grow on this soil. Now the next point is, it helps the plant to grow very nicely, as it gives support to the plants. So soil provides support to the plants, and that's how also it provides minerals and nutrients, the soil which is fertile soil. Okay, so it provides minerals and nutrients, then it provides support also to the plants. The roots of the plants get fixed into the soil. And next point, many rocks, now rocks and minerals you have studied, right? right? So you'll be knowing there are many minerals present in the soil, minerals and ores, which are very useful for human beings. Now, in total, we all know that plants are the producers, correct? So we all directly or indirectly depend on the plant for our nutrition and growth, right? That means when soil is giving support to the plant to grow and minerals and nutrients, and it is helping the plants to grow, then indirectly we all depend on the soil, and that is how we can call soil a very important resource for in our lives. Okay, now children, coming on to the next topic, that is layers of soil. So there are totally four layers of soil, children. Okay, so the first one is topsoil. After topsoil, next comes the subsoil. Then comes the weathered rock fragments. And the last one is bedrock. Now, let me show you a picture of this and explain to you. So, this is your textbook here, page number 201. This is the diagram for layers of soil. So now, here, the topmost, see, you can see a plant grown here with its root down, correct? Now, the very topmost layer, that is a very thin layer, okay? That is nothing but the humus. What is humus? Decaying organic matter, okay? Now, below that, you will find the first layer of the soil, that is called as topsoil. Okay, how is the topsoil? It is very dark in color, right? Because it is very nutrient rich soil. Okay, and it is rich in humus. That is why its color is very dark. And the seed, germination of the seed takes place in this layer. And some of the small plants root, they grow in this topsoil. Okay, the next layer is the subsoil. So you can differentiate between the topsoil and the subsoil, right? Topsoil is much darker than the subsoil. Now, subsoil, what happens is whenever the water falls on the topsoil, the minerals and the nutrients, they seep into the subsoil. They go further down to the subsoil. Here, nutrients, it won't be very nutrient rich like the topsoil. But yes, of course, it will be porous in nature. That means lot of holes or the gaps will be present in this subsoil. And this, the roots of bigger plants or trees, they grow to the subsoil. They grow in the subsoil. See here, you can see the root has gone down to the subsoil. And sometimes the big trees roots, they will reach the weathered rock fragments also, little bit, okay, not to the deepness. It will end to the subsoil majorly. Now this subsoil provides support to the plant. Now coming down to the next layer, that is weathered rock fragments. So this weathered rock fragments means small pieces of stones, big pieces of rocks will be present in this layer. Okay, this fragments, rock fragments have come from the parent material. Parent material means the bedrock, okay, which is full of rocky layer. From this thing, small pieces of rocks have been broken and they are present here in weathered rock fragments. This soil is not rich in nutrients, okay, and it can hold very little water. It is not very porous also. Now coming to the last layer, that is the bedrock layer. This bedrock layer consists of the unbroken rocky material. See here, you can see fragments, some fragments, but here it is completely full rock, right?
that is unbroken rocky material. So this layer of the soil, the water, you can find just above here, you can find the underground water. But what happened, we don't want simply underground water, we want the water to be distributed within the soil, correct, for the plants to grow. It should have a porous kind of material, the soil. But here, this rock, this bedrock layer, since being the rocky material, it is non-porous. And underground water is stored here, just above the rocky layer. Okay. So that means the rocky layer is not suitable for the growth of plants. Now, soil is a natural renewable resource. We have already learned what is the difference between a renewable resource and a non-renewable resource, right? So, renewable means which you can use again and again repeatedly. There will be enough sufficient amount of the resource for using them again and again. So, few more renewable resources are wind, water, solar. So, all these are renewable resources of energy. Now, as I am saying, soil is also one of the renewable resources. But still, it is under threat. It is under threat means it is in danger. The soil is in danger. We are about to lose many, rich layer of soil. Day by day, we are losing it. So, that term we call it as erosion of soil. What do we call that term as? Soil erosion. Now, let me define you what is soil erosion. So, soil erosion is nothing but when the uppermost layer of the soil is being carried away by the natural agents like wind, water, etc. from one place to another place, we call such an activity as a soil erosion. So when the uppermost layer of the soil, which is the uppermost layer? The top soil, which is very fertile in nature, correct? So when this uppermost layer is carried away by the natural agents, like wind, water, etc., from one place to another place, such an feature is called as a soil erosion. Okay. Now, I said natural agents, wind, water, but there are some human activities also which give rise to erosion of soil, such as human activities like overgrazing of animals, then deforestation as well. We'll study about the causes in the coming part. But first let us know what is the soil erosion, and we'll study first about the natural agents of soil erosion. Okay, that is water and then wind. Okay, so now, as I said, the topmost layer will be carried away by wind and water. Then, if the topmost layer is carried away, which is the most fertile part of the soil, then how the plants will grow? The plants require nutrients and minerals, right? The plants would not be able to grow properly. And if the plants won't grow, then the soil will be very loose, the support system is lost there. Easily the wind or the water can carry away the soil from one place to another. And also, if plant is not growing or crops are not growing in that place, soon the land will become barren. Barren means not fit for growing crops. Okay, that's how it is leading to a very dangerous situation in us. Okay. Now, the first one we'll study, the first natural agent is the water. So, water, in case of heavy rains, children, in case of heavy rainfall and floods, what happens? The water rushes.
the water rushes in a full speed, and this speed of the water or this velocity of the water causes the topmost layer, and sometimes the subsoil also comes get rooted up. Sorry, the plants in the subsoil get uprooted, and along with the plants the soil also gets carried away from one place to another. Okay, and that is how the water causes soil erosion. Now there are few examples given here. See, one example is the Chambal Valley of Madhya Pradesh. So especially the Chambal Valley of Madhya Pradesh, this valley, Chambal Valley, is formed because of this kind of erosion. The water, the river water which will be flowing in a very heavy, because of heavy rainfall and high currents of the water, what happens? It erodes away the layer, topmost layer of the soil. And what happens? Running water washes the soil off the hill slopes. This makes the slopes unfit for cultivation. So especially in case of slopes or mountain area. So this is a mountain region. Now when the water will fall, or there is a heavy rainfall, what happens? It falls in full force on this mountain, and whatever the soil, the good layer of the soil, fertile layer of the soil, will be washed away and it will be settled somewhere down here. That means this part of the region will become barren. Okay, so one such example is the Chambal Valley of Madhya Pradesh. Now a river coming down the hill carries lot of mud with it, isn't it? So down the hill when it comes, the river, it carries lot of mud with it. Now part, what happens is when it reaches the plain is the flat surface. When this water reaches the plain, it will slowly it will deposit the soil onto the plain surface. Okay, now what happens? Over some time the soil keeps accumulating, the rainfall happens and it brings away all the soil and it will accumulate here, okay, on the plains. Now the river which usually flows in this direction, okay, in this direction the flow will be okay normally, but because of the deposition of large amount of sand or soil, the river will change its direction, will change its course. So it will go to some other place, it might change its course, okay, it will not go in its regular direction. So if this kind of changing of course happens, the river can bring a lot of destruction in the nearby villages or the houses. Okay, so what happens? Heavily the water will come this way, it will go this way where the houses will be present. That means there will be loss of lives over here. So this kind of situation is also very dangerous. Okay, now next, coming on to the wind. Now you know slow moving air, we call it as a breeze or wind. Now strong currents are windy, we'll say. If lot of the breeze is very heavy, okay, the air is moving very fast and very strong, we call such air as a wind. So this wind, what it does, if the soil is just left out, okay, without any plants on them, it will wash away the topmost layer of the soil. It will carry away the topmost layer of the soil and it will deposit somewhere else. Okay, so, and again the land will become barren there. But if there is
presence of plants over here. Okay, then it will be difficult for the wind to take away the soil, as the roots of these plants will hold the soil firmly. Okay, so in desert and open lands, so especially in deserts and open lands or open areas, wind causes lot of erosion. Strong winds blow away the humus rich soil, that means the topmost fertile rock soil will erode away. When this fertile layer of soil is worn, new plants cannot grow well in this depleted soil. Depleted means which is less in the nutrients. Okay, so this was about the soil erosion caused by water and wind. So in the next class we shall learn about the human activities which lead to the soil erosion and some of the conservation methods for soil erosion. Okay, thank you.